In this video, I'm talking about why I only recommend premium level hearing aid technology. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Anthem, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. If you've spent any time at all researching hearing aids, you've probably identified that different manufacturers have different levels of hearing aid technology. The higher in technology level that you go, the more features that hearing aid will have, but they'll also cost you more money. So let's go over these different hearing aid features and see why they justify this additional expense. Number one is hearing better in background noise. Hearing aid manufacturers spend millions of dollars each year trying to reduce the signal-to-noise ratio of their hearing aids by a few decibels. But this few decibel reduction in signal-to-noise ratio can mean the difference between you hearing and understanding a friend that you're eating with at a restaurant or not hearing them and having to watch their mouth the entire time that you're eating. So the better technology level that you have, the better you'll hear in background noise. Number two is better automatic adjustment capabilities of the hearing aids. Premium level hearing aid technology does a better job of auto-identifying whatever environment that you're in and actually putting your hearing aids into the best program settings for that particular environment. So if you're the type of person who does not like to push a push button to change programs based on the environment that you're in, premium level hearing aids will help do that for you and do it better than you could do it on your own. Here's an example of a premium level hearing aid that has different program settings depending on which environment that you're in. If you're taking a car ride, the hearing aid automatically puts you into the car program. If you're in a restaurant, the hearing aid automatically identifies that you're in a noisy situation and either puts you into a speech and noise program or speech and loud noise program. If you're listening to music, the hearing aid will put you into a program that is designed specifically to leave music as natural as possible. If you want your hearing aids to just flat out work without you having to worry about making adjustments depending on the environment that you're in, then premium level hearing technology makes a lot of sense. And the third feature is more adjustment handles. Premium level hearing aids have more adjustment capability so the hearing care professional that you're working with can customize them even better. Think of a piano keyboard. Now imagine a piano keyboard with only 5 keys. If you restrict the amount of keys on a keyboard down to 5, your ability to play quality music would be extremely restricted. Most premium level hearing aids have up to 20 adjustment handles that can be used to program a hearing aid at very narrow frequency ranges, while basic hearing aid models can have as little as 3 adjustment handles that only allow for broad adjustments in the low, middle, and high frequency ranges. Not having enough adjustment handles can result in over-amplifying some areas for your hearing loss prescription while under-amplifying others. While having up to 20 adjustment handles will allow for almost an exact prescription match throughout your entire hearing loss range. Now these are all great reasons to recommend premium hearing aid technology, but the main reason that I primarily recommend premium level technology versus all other technology levels is because I do not want to leave any benefit on the table. If you end up going with lower levels of technology, you will be hearing better, but you're always going to find yourself in situations that you're going to be like, could I hear better in this situation? And the answer is most definitely yes. Now, naturally, I'm expecting some of you to say, of course you're recommending only premium hearing aid technology. That is what costs more, and you're a greedy guy, and you're trying to get as much money from your patients as possible. But the fact of the matter is that I actually make less money dispensing premium level technology than I do any other level, and that's because it costs me more to get those devices from a manufacturer. And I'd rather eat some of the cost of those premium level devices so my patients can hear better. Now, when you start to calculate out how much additional it will cost you to go from a second tier device up to a premium level device, you're looking at anywhere between $200 increase in cost for a single hearing aid up to $500 increase cost of a single hearing aid. And then when you look at for the lifespan of a hearing aid being around 4.4 years on average, and I would say that that's a pretty conservative estimate. I would say that you could probably get substantially longer than that if you take really good care of your devices, but let's just take 4 years, for instance. If you increase the cost of your technology by $400 to $1,000, you're only going to be spending really on average about $100 extra dollars to $250 extra dollars per year for both of your hearing aids. The way I see it is that people primarily come to me in my clinic because they want to maximize their hearing potential with their hearing devices. And so I can either try to accomplish that task with a lower level piece of hearing aid technology, which is like trying to program that hearing aid with my hands tied behind my back, or they can go with premium level technology that lets me do whatever I need to do to maximize their hearing potential. So the natural question is, do I ever fit someone with hearing aid technology that is not at the premium level? And the answer is, of course, yes. If there's patients who come into me with existing technology and they want me to fix the programming in those hearing aids, I'm absolutely happy to do that. And then there's other individuals who have residual hearing that is so bad that fitting them with a premium level device doesn't make any sense because they're not even gonna perceive all of the benefit from those devices. I typically think of these individuals as cochlear implant candidates, but for whatever reason, they either can't or don't want to go through surgery. Those are the individuals that I fit lower levels of technology on. Now, all this being said, paying for premium level hearing aid technology would be a waste of money if you don't have best practices performed on them during your hearing aid fitting, like real ear measurement. And let me show you what I'm talking about. Here is a graph that shows performance in background noise with a variety of high-tech premium level hearing aids and an old analog hearing aid. The shorter the bars, the better the user's performance in a noisy situation. The long black bars indicate the performance of a modern premium level hearing aid when that hearing aid is programmed without using real ear measurement. The shorter gray bars indicate the performance of these same hearing aids when they are programmed using real ear measurement. You can see that even an old analog hearing aid performs better than a modern premium technology level hearing aid when those hearing aids are not programmed using real ear measurement. I don't care how advanced the hearing aid is, it will not perform up to its full capacity without real ear measurement performed on them. Now, this is just one example of why you need real ear measurement performed on your hearing aids during your hearing aid fitting. Nearly every additional feature that you find in a premium level hearing aid will be negatively impacted if you do not have real ear measurement done on them. This basically means that you're gonna take whatever additional money that you spent on those premium level devices and flush it right down the toilet. So if you want to achieve whatever your max performance ability is, then premium level hearing aid technology is the way to go. But this is only if best practices are followed when fitting your hearing aids, and this includes real ear measurement. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I'll see you next time.